Welcome at Kempers Watersport. My name is Bart Kempers and I'm going to take you out on the Sea Ray SunSport 250 today on a beautiful day. Really nice light conditions. And as usual, I'd like to start at the front, but before I do so, I'd like to inform you about this Sea Ray SunSport 250 because it's more or less a similar boat to the Sea Ray SLX 250. The cockpit, watch our other videos, the cockpit is similar to this one on the Sea Ray SunSport 250. But from this part on, the boat is different. Where the cameraman is standing now, on the SLX there's a small toilet area. But in this boat, since there's in front a place to sleep, the toilet is stored underneath this floor. But I'll show you later on. But as I said, let's start at the bow. And coming from the bow, you see a big area here with anti-skid to be used stepping on board from a dock or even from a beach. And this Sea Ray SunSport 250 is also equipped with an electric anchor winch and with a beautifully finished stainless steel anchor. Notice the gas strut, the remote for the anchor winch. And of course, for emergency situations, if you don't have power, there's also a manual piece which you can use to lower the anchor or take it up. LED navigation lights and this railing, the higher bow railing which is used on the SunSport, also in combination with the sun cushions on the bow, a really nice place to be out on the sun, in the sun. We tend to sell this SunSport 250 to people using it in areas where they're either eager to sleep over during a weekend or so, or what I also sometimes hear is that people use it on areas such as Garda Lake where the weather can change quickly and people tend to be slightly careful with an open bow. A closed bow gives you slightly more protection. And of course, also if it does change quickly, it is quicker to just leave it as it is, go to the marina, and you don't have to worry about the bow getting wet because this can all handle a drop of water, of course, and a quick shower. And as I said, stainless steel high bow railing. There's a lower railing here also. If you do lie down here and if somebody passes by with big waves, you can grab onto this. We didn't fit the filler piece for this hatch, because when we go inside, we of course like to have some natural light, but there is a filler piece here also, so that the full bow is covered with a nice thick cushion. Notice also the stitching on the sides and some nice detailing with these contrasting leather style look. And of course, this is all high quality upholstery, which can handle direct sunlight and some water. And as I always say in my videos, the back part is made in a way that it's ventilated also, so that it lasts longer, because cushions do tend to get wet every now and then. And of course, this can all be covered. Please notice these and this zipper here. There's a cover which goes over the full sun lounge on the bow, so that you can protect it from the elements. What I didn't tell you is that stainless steel, like on all Sea Ray and Boston Whaler boats, is made out of stainless steel of a 316 quality, which is the best available in the water sports industry. And notice also the nice hinges, cleats with the Sea Ray logo on. Those are the details that make a Sea Ray a Sea Ray. What I sometimes also say is that if you do want to compare quality, please check boats which are 20 years old or so with the Sea Ray. A piece strengthening the fiberglass is molded in while building the boat in order to make this very sturdy and solid. What you see if you look at boats of 20 years old of other brands is that you see cracks here. And that is caused, of course, by a builder not using beckoning material at the cleats, which Sea Ray always does. Okay, let's go to the back. And of course, you can close this. A nice curved windshield here. And this is the step-on for the bow. But maybe it's easier if the cameraman comes down first so that they can open up the front cabin. Put the safety latch out so that it doesn't close with my fingers in between. And this is meant as a sleepover for a weekend or so. Notice that it's still quite big. I always say that I'm 1.93 meters and I can even sit upright without hurting my or touching the ceiling with my head. Again here, nice detailing. This is all covered with a leather style material. These pieces are covered. Nice cushions on the sides. Thick cushions and the bunks here. And I'll show you also that this is actually quite big. As you notice, I mean, I'm 1.93. If I go all the way to the end, I still have maybe even half a meter of space there. And of course, there's a fillet piece for this area, so that you have a really long but also wide sleeping area. And underneath this here, I won't take it out. That'll be too much for this short video. But there's a toilet, which also, of course, as a holding tank. Let me lock the safety latch while I'm at it. Reading light on that side, portholes for ventilation and also for some natural light. And as I mentioned earlier, an escape hatch here, but also allowing sunlight to come in with a good mosquito net. So if you do sleep on the boat, you do have a way to protect or to keep the mosquitoes out. There's a reading light there, but there are two on that side and speakers inside. So still a really good place to stay for longer periods. Toilet, by the way, is also available in an electric version. Okay, before I forget, of course, the place underneath the bunks is also used for storage. There's plenty of storage. Notice how high these are. So you can imagine that there's plenty of storage area underneath. Indirect lighting here, which gives a nice touch in on nice summer evenings. And all these paneling is all covered by a leather look upholstery. Okay, stainless steel thresholds here. Nice detailing and also very practical, but because you do step on this quite often, and if it's simple fiberglass, it'll damage over the years. Not when this is protected with stainless steel. Okay, going to the steering position. A beautifully stitched with diamond pattern backrest of this steering seat with nice SLX logos, nice gray piping, and this contrast again coming back, which gives it a luxurious look of the Sunsport, which, as I mentioned earlier, is also used on the SLX, which people tend to refer to as the premium family of Sea Ray boats. So we're really thrilled with this Sunsport, which now also has this really luxurious feel to it. Notice all these details. All this is covered. Double stitches here and here on the areas where you tend to, well, touch it. Every now and then you lean on this side, but this lasts for a long time because of these double stitches, which is also used here. And nice chrome bezels with the Sea Ray logo, and we're more or less used to it. But if I look at other brands, you hardly ever see a logo of the brand. But that also has to do with Sea Ray being the biggest boat builder worldwide. So they have some scale of economics, I think they call it, so that they have the possibility to actually have their own Sea Ray logo in. Okay. Dashboard with all the switches. I won't go over all the switches. There's of course switches which have a light in, so you can see if you leave them on accidentally. Bow thruster is an option on the Sunsport 250, which I, by the way, certainly recommend, because if you drive alone or in difficult conditions going back in the marina, going into the dock, this is very useful and makes life a lot easier. I sometimes see in the marina people being scared of going out, because if they come on the marina and they see that it's a force 5, they think, we might as well stay on the boat in the marina. because we're afraid to get in when we come back. But if you do have a bow thruster, you just go out because you don't worry about getting back into the mooring. This boat, as an option, is equipped with active trim. I won't go into detail because there are other videos on active trim. And another feature, which is an option on the SunSport and the SLX, but it is not on the boat, is dynamic running surface. Please check other videos on dynamic running surface. That is an option and a feature which is unique to Sea Ray. It gives you lots of nice possibilities to adjust the trim tab installation, and also in combination with a special hull shape, so that you can have special wakes for wake surfing, wakeboarding, or even especially low wakes for monoskiing. A really nice system, unique to Sea Ray, so please check other videos on that. You can also control the anchor winch from here, which is of course also a safety feature if something does happen in rivers with a quite strong current. It's a safe thought to be able to lower the anchor from here. And of course the simple between brackets trim tabs can also be controlled from the steering position. There's an MP3 connection and the USB connection here. A nice stainless steel cup holder with a battery for the camera now. But so that is, and of course there's plenty of place to store other stuff here. There's a speaker here, and as you noticed before in the cabin there are two speakers, so two in the bow, two here, and there's a subwoofer on this boat also, which is an option. You can have the audio upgrade with a more powerful amplifier and the subwoofer, which gives it a more rich sound. The steering wheel, as usual, is adjustable like this. There's a main switch here, which I find very convenient. You don't have to open up the engine hatch, you just put it on and off right here with the touch of a button. Courtesy lights right here and there and on other places in the back. And going to the other end, we have a backrest here, which can also be lifted and pulled down like this, so you have a really, sorry about this, and now I see that we forgot to clean that because the backrest was in front of it. But there's a long place here to actually lie in the sun, especially in spring when the water is still cold and everybody wants to get out, and you get under the water and you think, it's still kind of chilly. You lower this piece, you put out the anchor, and being sheltered by this windshield, you'll be able to enjoy the first sun rays of spring. And of course it can be lifted fully like I just showed, but also in this position so that you can actually sit here and on a day such as today look over the water in a very comfortable way. Grab rails on different places. This I find also very useful, a really nice table with a piece like this. Beautiful detailing with the Sea Ray logo and a place to put beverages. And like this you can open it up. Of course it's turnable like this also. And as you can see, I'm not the biggest person, but still, if you count, I think you can have 6-7 people even around this table here. A really nice and comfortable place to sit. Grab rail here, high backrests, the seat base is long enough. I always notice, especially on smaller boats, that builders tend to make these shorter, which just does not feel right if you stay here for a longer time. You really actually do get tired, not on the Sea Ray such as this. And what helps also is that this small piece is slightly higher, so that you're more or less safely blocked like this, and it just feels very comfortable. Again, the diamond stitching here, contrasting leather here, stainless steel here, which is some nice detailing. This table can also be lowered. There's another support below this cushion, which comes up to here, so that you can lower the table and use a filler cushion and have a huge sunbed here, There's another sunbed which I'll show later on the back. But again, in early spring, if it's still kind of chilly, this is a great place to stay in the sun and be sheltered by the windshield. And what I nearly forgot is that there's indirect lights. I think it's an option underneath these cushions, which gives a really nice and classy look during evenings and nights. Okay, I'm just thinking if there's anything I forget. Of course, there are other cup holders there. Sea Ray logo on the back. A nice bimini with stainless steel supports as usual, and some umbrella fabric here, which keeps it protected against mildew, etc. And going this way, this can be used as a walkthrough also, but we put the cushions on now and I'll leave it like it is and be less gentle, quickly jump over the cushions. But this can be used as a walkthrough if you take that cushion out, and of course this can be taken out also. Which brings me to a nice feature on this place, because this can be used like this. And as you can see, this is a great place to lie down, read a book, with this nice support for your head and neck. And you can actually enjoy the sun from here. Again, cup holders for stainless steel. And a quite long sunbed. If you lower this, the beam of the boat is, I think, by heart 2 meters, 59 centimeters. So you can imagine that this is over 2 meters wide, and everybody can lie down here and enjoy the sun. Coming to the swimming platform, this one is covered with something called sea deck, which is a really nice soft material. Does well, hardly needs any maintenance, just simple cleaning, and feels very comfortable to the feet. And also it adds to the ease and the comfortable way putting a wakeboard or water skis on. And this boat is also fitted with something called a submersible swim platform, which I'll show like this. Really convenient way to put a wakeboard on, because people who do wakeboarding will recognize that it can be quite cumbersome putting a wakeboard on the swimming platform. But like this, imagine having a wakeboard, just putting it on, and you can actually more or less step in, which makes it very easy to put it on or take it off. Kids also like to use it as a jump in the water platform. And sometimes people even do not use the swimming ladder, but use this to go in and out of the water. But of course, there's also a swimming ladder on the starboard side, long enough, 3 steps, so a really good possibility to get in and out of the water. And of course, I'll quickly slide over to this side. Ergonomics on the Sea Ray are always excellent. A grab rail to get out of the water on the right place. Solid hinges for the engine edge. And I think that more or less covered it. One thing, there's a piece here which you use to put the water ski line in, but of course there are other options like putting a tower on, so you can have a higher drawing point, so to say. I'm not sure whether that is correct English, because I'm native Dutch, but still, you can have either this as a standard or a tower with a higher point, which people who do wakeboarding actually like, jumping wake to wake, as they call it. A higher point where the line is attached to makes that simple and easier. But that is an option which is not fitted on this boat. Okay, I'll lower this one. I just put my phone out. This is a small app, so I can see the accurate speed. Doing 8 kilometers an hour now, which is nice, slow driving for Dutch canals, lakes and rivers. I'll put this down so that the wind won't take the noise or won't bring the noise in my microphone for the video. I usually like to sit up with the flip-up seat, because you have a better overview, and on a beautiful day such as today, I think it's even over 25 degrees centigrade. I like to have the wind through my hair and the sun on my head, I always say, but this is really convenient also. Again, I'm not the tallest guy, but I'm not small either. And I have a really good place to sit here with a long seat base, high backrest. This is extremely wide and more or less curved in a way that you're sheltered and sit in a very comfortable way. You can lean your arm here. So it all, as I mentioned before, ergonomics on the Sea Ray is always excellent. Okay, off we go. I'm not pushing the throttle really hard because of the cameraman, but this boat is equipped with the optional 300 horsepower V8, which is an excellent engine for this 25-foot boat. But if you actually put it all the way down, driving slowly, well, it more or less jumps out of the water. Doing 37 kilometers an hour, little less than 3000 RPM, really nice cruising speed, and it's still very little noise from the engine. You hear the wind in the water more than you hear the engine. Let me go in the other way, so we have some more room on the lake. Steering is really nice and easy. You can actually do it with a finger like this. And of course this boat with this optional 300 horsepower Bravo 3 stern drive and DTS, digital throttle and shift. The shifting is really easy and light, and it also reduces the noise because you don't have the cable which take engine noise through the cables. These are eliminated, so but it's less quiet because of that also. Okay, doing 3400 RPM, 46 kilometers an hour. Let me use the trim slightly. 50 kilometers an hour just by using the trim. Let me see what she can do. Sixty-seven, sixty-eight, 70 kilometers an hour. 71. Really good. 72 even. Okay, let me take the throttle down a bit, make a slight turn. No noises, no rattling, nothing. Feels very reliable, stable. Of course there's no wind now, so no wakes, but we've tried it earlier. And like we're used to on the Sea Ray SLX 250, it's a great hull and it just performs excellent. Which brings me to the end of this review. Let me take the throttle down. Thank you for watching. If you do have comments, please leave them behind below this video in the remarks session. Any questions, remarks, feel free to ask them and leave them behind. Thank you for watching again. See you next time. Happy boating.